Boxing star Fernando Guerrero is working hard at the Goose and Jimmy Van Nuys, preparing for his big fight that's going down February 11th. So what's the deal? We're here at Goose and Jimmy Van Nuys. Fernando Guerrero in the house. Ricky Funes.
Doing the old Joe Goosen hand wrap, man.
What's the Joe Goosen hand wrap?
Right here. Toilet paper on the knuckles, so won't be no friction, and make it like a parade.
Toilet paper? That's toilet a secret?
Paper. Yeah. No, a lot of people use that. Close.
Some people use other stuff.
Yeah. Come on, Ellie. Man, Ellie, you're good. But you ain't
so, have you ever seen a jump rope routine quite like Fernando Guerrero?
No, never.
That was sick, huh?
Yeah. I thought Mayweather was good at it.
I thought Pacquiao, Amir Khan, Mayweather, but Fernando Guerrero, if there was a contest, Fernando, you'd win the gold medal in that one.
Well, you know, it's just all a good day, hard work, that's all.
Yo, what's up with Amir Khan thinking about that suspect guy? That suspicious guy working with the...
Well, I think he was an IBF official on his day off. Now, where I'm from, on your day off, you don't work, so why was he working on his day off?
True, like, the whole thing with the Amir Khan situation, the WBA already mandated a rematch with him and Lamont Peterson. So he's receiving some criticism for, you know, the ongoing blaming of a lot of different things for the fight. I think he should just go on with the rematch. Because, you know...
Who wins?
In the rematch, probably Amir Khan. He didn't fight. He had a horrible fight on his first fight. And Lamont deserved to win that fight.
So you say Khan wins. What do you say?
I like Lamont. I think Lamont, if he puts that pressure, like he kept pausing and stopping. If he puts that pressure from the get-go on the next rematch, I think he'll give Khan a lot of problems.
Fernando Guerrero told me Lamont Peterson beats Manny Pacquiao.
I don't know.
He sparred him. He knows him. He worked out with him, right?
I don't know. It'll be a tough fight. Very tough.
It's a little bit hard for to ask me because just been working with the guys, so I know that I'm choosing a little bit of favoritism. But it's just me knowing, you know, what he can do.
Yeah.
And just being in the ring with him. So, you know, even though if of course, you know, if Pacquiao wins and everything like that, but I can never.
You still gotta go for your boy.
I gotta go for my boy.
What do you think?
Like Berto being here, you know, I think Berto's gonna win. You know, people are just saying, oh, just because he's in the Goosen's gym, you know, training there, he's gonna choose just, Berto.
We see what we're doing.
Well, you spar Berto, so you know how hard he hits, you know how he moves, how he's fast. He has a lot of swagger.
Got a lot of swagger, you know, and you know, a lot of times in boxing, as I know, you get a bad day, you know, but it's how you get up, and the way that, I mean, with that loss, and he still has the same swagger, like, I'm the champ, I'm, you know, the Haitian sensation, man, you know, so it's nice, you know.
Haiti is the other part of your island. You're from the Dominican Republic, so Berto told me you guys are brothers.
Well, we have to, you know, yeah, you know, it's just like I tell people, you know, if you know hunger, you know me, and in Haiti, there's a lot of hunger, you know, so when they see me training and stuff, you know, I'm not going for the gold medal. It's a privilege for me to be here in America and train, you know, because my parents brought me here.
Well, Ricky, you're from El Salvador, right?
Ellie, you know what, you're going to get your ass beat, man. Ellie, that's twice in 1 week, man. I'm Dominican today, man. I got to blend in. Hey, just like Fernando told me, I got to blend in. I'm a chameleon.
Chameleon. You look more Cuban, doesn't he?
I get Indian.
I look more Cuban.
Right. I get Indian. I get Puerto Rican. With a gray hair.
I'm just black African American, that's all I am.
But nobody expects you to speak Spanish, Fernando.
No, I freaked them out. I'm like, hey, hola, ¿cómo está? ¿Estamos bien?
No, but everybody can say that over here.
That's a great surprise, man.
Yeah, but not with an accent.
Not with an accent? Sometimes I'm surprised that Ricky can speak English.
Right. I'm still learning.
Nah, he's cool. He's a good dude. Hey, one time I went to a restaurant with him. I don't know if you saw the video. With Edison Miranda. Should I tell him the story?
Yes.
Don't turn your back on Ricky Funes in a restaurant. He put the whole hot sauce inside a soda. So Edison Miranda comes back after paying the bill and he takes a thing. He almost had a heart attack. He was jumping up and down. You remember that?
Because every time I would step away from a table, I would come back, he'll put it like hot sauce or extra salt on my food. So one day he just stepped out of nowhere and I put a lot of hot sauce on the soda. He came back and that.
So there you have it, Fernando Guerrero. Look out for him for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Sec Back reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @SecBack.